My dear friends, this video will describe a simple maneuver wherein you can exploit the fluid dynamics to increase the fallibility of nuclear fragments during phacoemulsification. So let's take a look at a small video clip. Now, as you watch this video clip, you must be wondering that the fallibility in this particular case is not too exciting or too impressive. There are certain mistakes that you can see. You can see that the surgeon is excessively moving the phaco tip back and forth. The surgeon also attempts to run after the fragments instead of allowing the fragments to come towards him into the phaco tip. The fallibility in this case, where the vacuum is set at 350 millimeters of mercury in a Venturi machine, is okay, but it is not very good. The excessive movements of the phaco tip by the surgeon is not really helping in increasing the fallibility of the pieces. That's pretty obvious. Now, this is the video which would fit into the before category, and this is the way I was doing the fragment removal until I stumbled upon a simple maneuver by which I can increase the fallibility a great deal. Now, let's take a look at a second clip and observe the fallibility of nuclear fragments. The vacuum setting in this case is exactly the same as the previous case. The nucleus grade is also exactly the same. However, you can see that the fallibility has improved a great deal. Now, what you notice is that the surgeon is keeping the phaco tip or phaco handpiece steady in the center of the eye. He's not chasing after the pieces, he's not excessively moving the phaco tip around or waving it around. But in spite of this, there is a magnetic fallibility of the pieces that simply seem to disappear into the phaco tip. There's also a great deal less amount of chatter, and the nucleus fragment seems to remain almost stuck to the phaco tip. Now, this is not just simply holding the phaco tip steady. There's also a slight maneuver that I am doing. And before I explain what this maneuver is, let's look at some basic facts. And let's consider what we mean by fluid dynamics. The fluid flow into the anterior chamber issues out from the side openings of the phaco sleeve, which is oriented at right angles to the phaco tip. Consider that the volume of the anterior chamber is just 0.3 ml of fluid. Now, when an aspiration flow rate of 30 cc per minute is set, the volume of fluid flowing through the anterior chamber is 100 times the anterior chamber volume every minute, and this is quite a lot of flow. In foot pedal 1, the infusion starts. When the anterior chamber pressure is equilibrated with the bottle height, further flow will stop. The aspiration flow will begin only with foot pedal 2. Now, this will produce a significant conductive flow issuing from the irrigating port of the silicone sleeve, carrying the nuclear fragments towards the phaco tip. Now, according to Dr. Dodick and Dr. Donenfeld, there exists something known as the triangle of tranquility just in front of the tip, from which the nuclear fragments get sucked into the phaco tip, which is generated by the flow of fluid. As you can see, this high pressure chaotic flow gets organized in the center just anterior to the tip, called the triangle of tranquility. And as the pieces come into this zone, they get easily aspirated in the phaco tip. The flow, which is about 100 times the volume of the anterior chamber, helps to pick up the pieces and propel them to the tip. Now, this we all know is known as fallibility. If the tip is not held steady, or if you move the tip to chase after the fragments, this flow gets disorganized and can lead to chaotic non-fallibility, excessive chatter, or pieces being pushed away from the phaco tip. In order to maximize the benefit of flow dynamics, the phaco tip should be held steady in the center of the anterior chamber. However, this flow is uniplanar and occurs only in the plane of the opening of the silicone sleeve, which is oriented at right angles to the phaco tip. However, it is not enough to simply hold the tip steady. The tip should be gently swiveled on its long axis by 10 to 15 degrees. Now, this is because the fragments are not all in one plane and can exist at various three-dimensional planes. Swiveling the tip will cause the irrigation flow to propel these fragments towards the tip. Now let's look at the swivel maneuver, which I'd like to describe to you, and how it helps in increasing the flowability. This is a grade 2 nuclear sclerotic cataract. I'm performing the direct phaco chop in my usual fashion, creating multiple small fragments. The power and the phaco mode settings should be commensurate to the grade of cataract and nuclear sclerosis. So once I create these multiple fragments, now it's time for fragment removal. And this is where I have changed my technique. I hold the phaco probe in the center of the eye and I apply a mild swivel, and you can see how the pieces are disappearing. And now for this fragment, I am not swiveling the phaco tip, I'm just holding it straight. Even though the followability is good, we depend on the flow that occurs in one plane only. And sometimes the pieces that are not in the plane of flow does not get aspirated. But if you swivel the phaco handpiece along its long axis to about just 5 to 10 degrees on either side, not too much that you will cause iris flutter, but just a little amount of swivel. Now you will see that I'm swiveling the phaco tip slightly. You can see from the bevel face that I'm gently swiveling it. The act of simply swiveling it around will increase the fallibility significantly. This is because the flow dynamics will now move in different planes and will help to propel the three-dimensionally located phaco pieces towards the phaco tip. Now this is the basis of what I call a swivel maneuver. Now what should we really avoid while doing fragment removal? Let's look at another old case that I have done. Do not excessively move the tip around. So when you move the tip around, the triangle of tranquility gets corrupted and disrupted. And therefore the pieces, instead of moving towards the tip, will actually move away from the tip, sometimes increasing the amount of nucleus chatter. Don't go chasing after the piece, because you should allow the aspiration flow rate to automatically propel the fragment pieces towards the phaco tip. Too much of movement of the tip will cause aberrant fluid currents and can lead to nucleus chatter or lens chatter, as it's very obviously seen in this case. So this is how you need to take this. So once you crack the piece and you got the fragment, you hold the phaco tip steady in the center of the eye. If things are happening well, then you don't have to swivel. But if there is a momentary drop in fallibility, then gently swivel the phaco tip by 5 to 10 degrees on either side. You hold the piece and then you have to gently swivel the. And you can see that I'm gently swiveling it around 5 to 10 degrees, and immediately the fallibility dramatically increases. So this, dear colleagues, is what I discovered quite by serendipity. I found that the fallibility has greatly improved once I've adopted this technique. I hope you try it too, and let me know if it also works in your hands. I thank you for your attention.